Breaking news out of Canberra, and former Labor leader and NDIS minister Bill Shorten has officially announced his retirement from politics. Ashley Raper joins us at the desk. Ash, Mr Shorten has announced he will not be contesting the next election.
Yes, Narelda, it was a shock announcement this morning that Bill Shorten will retire, and he will stay in Parliament, though, and on the front bench until February, when he takes up his new job as Vice-Chancellor of the University of Canberra. He's been a big player in the Labor Party, a powerful factional leader. He started out in the Australian Workers' Union, which he led. In that job as National Secretary, he rose to prominence during the Beaconsfield mine disaster in Tasmania. He entered Parliament a year later when Labor was swept to power in the Kevin 07 election, so he's been the member for the safe Labor seat of Maribyrnong in Melbourne's western suburbs for 17 years. Bill Shorten went on to lead the Labor Party in opposition from 2013 until 2019, when Labor had a bruising defeat to the Morrison government. He's reflected on his political career, saying he's had some extraordinary highs and extraordinary lows.
Regrets. I might borrow from someone else. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, but much more than this, I did it my way.
Bill Shorten is currently the Minister for the NDIS, and he's just gone through a very tough negotiation to get reforms which were aimed at making the scheme more financially sustainable through Parliament. It means a lot of change for the scheme, and there's still a lot of work that needs to be done. And that's the reason the Prime Minister has given for Bill Shorten staying on as Minister until he retires. We are approaching an election. It has to be held before mid-May, but the Prime Minister hosed down any suggestion today that a general election would coincide with Bill Shorten bowing out in February. Narelda.
All right, thanks for that, Ash.